So why are you so excited about AI and the opportunities that are going to present themselves right now in 2025, 2026, et cetera? I was just listening to a podcast with the director of AI over at Tesla, Andrej Karpathy, and he broke it down in a way that really made sense to me. And I'll kind of break down these three steps that I think are really interesting. I'll go into that in just a second. But what I do want to say, if you're like me, you're a creator at heart. You're a creator at heart. You like to build things. And again, I think now is perhaps the best time in human history to actually do that because of the speed, because of the reduced risk. I mean, historically, if you're going to create a startup, a software startup, there's immense risk. I have a buddy of mine who launched an app that connected. It's kind of like Patrick Bet-David's Manect app. It's called Owl. And essentially what it does is it connects customers with experts, and you can get on calls and you pay, you know, whatever the price is for 15 minutes. Anyway, he developed this app and it cost tens, hundreds of thousands of dollars. Incredibly expensive, incredibly time consuming. But what's interesting now, and what Andrej mentioned, is that we're in a time where an average person like you and me can actually write code. And let me get into what Andrej said. So basically he said that we're in a new phase of software. The first phase of software was, you know, when Bill Gates was in his garage just creating a computer, building out Windows, etc., you know. And then the second phase we went into was when the internet was developed, is the second phase of software. But now we're entering the third phase of software, and with AI. It's the third generation of software. And how is it so dramatically different? Well, previously, before, if you were going to create a piece of software, you needed to learn coding. You need to learn JavaScript, JSON, CSS, whatever, all these different types of codes. And when I was younger, my parents put me in a coding class. I hated it. I just couldn't do it. I couldn't sit. I need to get out and move. But anyway, you couldn't do that. But now, what's interesting is you don't need to know code. The way that we program now is with English. It's with words. It's with prompts. And when he said this, it really kind of put the pieces together for me as to why prompts and prompt engineering is so important, because the better you are at using your words, the more concisely and precisely that you can command these AI agents, the better results you're going to get, the better the software you're going to be able to create. So that's where I'm at with some of the projects that I'm working on. I remember back when I was in high school, we had these graphing calculators. All my millennials, my Gen Xers probably remember these graphing calculators, like the TI-83 Plus. Ooh, so cool. Unbelievable. Anyway, what I like to do is I like to create games. So I created this like snake game in the TI-83 Plus. I created like a quiz. It was like a 20 question quiz that had different results and different trees based on the answers. I really enjoyed building that. But now why I'm so excited, why I think you should be so excited, is that we can experience that again. I'm telling you guys, if you haven't yet, you got to check out Replit. And that's kind of my drug of choice. There's different AI agents and SaaS builders out there, but Replit is what I'm building. I'm building out a couple different projects. I talked about those in the last episode. But what's so profound about this period in time that we're in right now is that everyone has the chance to be a SaaS developer. And kind of going back to what I mentioned in the beginning, and why I'm so excited, A, I can actually get involved and write code using my words by being a better prompt engineer, by understanding how to communicate better with these AI agents. But just to recap, is that reduction in risk, because what used to cost hundreds of thousands of dollars now costs tens, or maybe even thousands of dollars. And while you and me prompt engineering and building out a SaaS software is not going to be excellent, probably at some point you're going to want to bring in a developer, but what it does allow us to do is create minimum viable products, MVPs. You're able to create an MVP that's going to be usable, that you can ship, and it's probably going to be pretty basic at first, but we can test the waters, guys. you could build a software in a weekend. Within 40 hours, you could have a software that you can ship out and test. You can solve interesting problems using these softwares, and you can test them. And then if people like it, if people buy it, well, then you build out. You become obsessive over that. Alex Becker over at Hyros had a post about this the other day. He said, you know, you're trying to do too much for too many people. Just focus on this one group, focus on a big problem that they have, make sure it's got a good market cap and there's enough customers and that they have money to actually purchase, that all important things. But find that, become obsessive over solving that problem. At least where my head's at is I'm willing to put it out there and fail, to try different things and fail. Because, you know, if you have a good SaaS software, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, you feel free to disagree in the comments, but you only need to win once. You might take 10 swings, but if you hit it once, it's a home run. Your life has changed. You have financial freedom, you're changing lives. And so that's kind of where I'm at. I want to keep putting out minimum viable products, keep testing the waters till I find something that really hits. And again, just walking and talking with y'all, this is my way of kind of giving back, explaining what I'm thinking about and how I'm kind of living through this really, really special era. And I hope that you are as well. This is the time, guys. We have a probably 12, 18, 24 month window to really, really find opportunities. Not to say that after 18 months, it's going to be done. But here's a problem that I think a lot of young entrepreneurs are running into. Again, everyday people like you and me, I'm not talking about MIT software developers, but regular people have actually a chance to take a swing and take a shot in the SaaS industry solving problems. If you are astute, can solve problems and find the opportunities. But the reason why this next 18 months is special is because nobody knows what the hell is going on. And if you're watching this video, you're in like the top 1% of people that actually understand or getting an understanding of what's going on. Because what a lot of young entrepreneurs run into is they say, oh, this guy made a lot of money through Go High Level, or this guy made money through ClickFunnels, or this guy made money doing this, or this guy made money doing that. Guys, the game has changed. Whatever has worked in the past, I don't care. I might take lessons from that, or I might build software that helps those types of businesses, but don't focus on what's worked in the past. Focus on solving interesting problems now. That's where I'm at. I'm not saying this is advice. This is where my head's at. I'm not interested in what's worked in the past. I'm interested in what is something I can do now to change the game. And by the way, y'all, this video is a little bit shorter. I didn't have enough time to like really capture all my thoughts because I'm in the middle of a move. This is a new neighborhood. I'm living out of boxes right now, which has also gotten me thinking about different ways I can create AI software to help with moving. But you should be thinking, I'm thinking about all the problems that people are experiencing and where AI can fit in. And by the way, just a side note, I think that probably the best places to look have something to do with AI voice. I talked about this in yesterday's video. AI voice is extremely good, and I think underrated. And again, 6 months, 12 months, 18 months, the jig is gonna be up. People are gonna have figured it out, but you have a head start now to start playing. And you might say, Mark, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to start. I'm confused, and that's okay. We all start there, but get some ideas with ChatGPT, bounce some ideas, spend a couple hours bouncing some ideas. This is what I'm doing. Go into Replit, start prompting, start building out software in there, start building out databases, start figuring it out. And it's gonna pay off big time. And by the way, at least where my head's at, even if I don't create a multi-million dollar software to exit, which I plan on doing, by the way, I plan on doing that. Even if that doesn't happen, I'm still going to become extremely valuable in the job market because I actually know how these tools work and I'm thinking ahead. So that's where I would challenge you. And I mentioned this because when Andrej was talking about us being in the next new generation of software, that really hit me. Because now's the time, guys. Now's the time. Go get it.